The Do More Bricks PLC has a register match option for generating interrupts. What does that mean? Well, suppose you set up input X0 to be a high-speed counter of some kind, and you want to know when the count reaches some specific number. And you don't want to wait for the next scan to come around to find out about it when all the regular inputs get updated, because it might be too late. Instead, you want to know about it right away so you can react accordingly. Well, that smells like an interrupt thing, right? And that's what this register matching interrupt option is all about. You can trigger an interrupt on one of three dedicated counter timer accumulators or one of three output pulse counters. Let's do a couple examples and see how this works. Assume the counter has been set up correctly. That's a subject for another video. And we want to react when that counter reaches 1, 2, 3, 4. Create a new ISR, and we want it to execute that ISR when a high-speed counter timer 1 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Hit OK, and we see an equation that says execute the ISR when this counter is equal to this number. Perfect. In the ISR, we'll set output Y3 with an immediate set command. So we should see output Y3 turn on when the input accumulator equals 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's do the exact same thing with function 2, but when the accumulator equals 1500, we'll turn Y3 off. So we're going to need another ISR to turn Y3 off. And when that same accumulator is equal to 1500, we want to execute that ISR routine. And in that ISR, we'll use an immediate reset instruction to turn Y3 off, so it'll turn off immediately and not wait for the bottom of scan like all of the other outputs. Accept all that, write it out, and make sure the PLC is back in run mode. I've connected one output from an encoder to input X3 on the PLC. Here's a data view that shows the input counter's accumulator and its reset control, the output we're controlling, and the run counter for both ISRs so we can see how many times they've been triggered. I'll hit the reset to make sure the accumulator is clear before we start. If I rotate the encoder up to the 1, 2, 3, 4 we specified, sure enough, output Y3 turns on, and we can see that that ISR ran one time. If I keep rotating to 1500, Y3 turns off, and its ISR ran one time. Perfect. And again, Y3 turned on and off immediately when the input changed. It didn't wait until bottom of scan. Which means now you have an accurate way to react to high-speed input counters and timers without having to wait until the top of the scan, which is really great for monitoring and reacting to high-speed inputs. You can do the same thing with high-speed outputs. Suppose you set up a motion axis to control some piece of machinery, and you want to know exactly when the axis reaches a certain position. Well, it's the exact same thing we just did, except you set up the interrupt service routine to trigger on the output register instead of the input accumulator. A word of caution about using interrupts to monitor output pulses. If you think you need to react to high-speed outputs using interrupts, hold that thought for a second and go take a look at the table-driven output commands. They do the same thing, but they run in the background in their own dedicated hardware, so they don't have any impact on the scan time. And you can even specify a whole sequence or table of events to watch for and react to. This says when the output counter gets to this value, set the output, and when it gets to this value, clear the output, etc. You can even see a plot of it here. Very cool. There's separate videos that show you how to do all of that. The key thing to understand is the interrupt register matching method we did in this video interrupts the scan, which could affect your performance, and it only responds to a single event. We had to create two different ISRs just to turn Y3 on and back off again, didn't we? The good news with the ISR is you can do whatever you want. You can set an internal bit, modify a register, record the date, etc. The preset table and table-driven output instructions can only set the one output. You can't do things like record the date and time and manipulate registers and stuff like that. So just know that you do have a choice when you need to respond quickly to high-speed outputs. And when you do need interrupts, well, as you can see, the Do More's interrupt system is extremely capable, and it'll usually be more than you could ever need. One side note, it's tempting to use the immediate instructions everywhere. I mean, why wait for the bottom of the scan for anything, right? Well, you could do that, but it's really not a good idea. PLCs are designed to read the inputs at the start of the scan, do the ladder logic, then update all the outputs at the end of the scan. Using immediate output instructions outside of an interrupt service routine is a good way to get things confused and to make your code really hard to debug. So avoid that temptation. If you need any help with the Do More PLC, please contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning support team during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help. And don't forget the forums. There's lots of automation professionals there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any questions directed at Automation Direct support team there. They don't monitor the forums on a regular basis. Spend less, do more with Automation Direct.